Hello students, as there are very few days left for your exams, I will be posting more and more questions daily. So please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you get daily updates on the questions posted. So without wasting much time, let us move on to the next question. Today's question is, explain the social condition of Aryans. So like all other 5-mark question, as I have told you, let us start with the introduction. Aryan, the word Aryan means noble or person dependent on agriculture. The Aryans were much different from the Dravidians. So the word Aryan means noble or a person dependent on agriculture. The Aryans were different from the Dravidians. Just a simple introduction for a 5-mark question. Now we directly move on to the answer. Social condition of Aryans. The Aryans had a joint family system. Their society was patriarchal. So what do we mean by patriarchal society? Patriarchal means the eldest male member will be the head of the family. So they had a joint family system. And their society was patriarchal, that means the eldest male member will be the head of the family. The eldest male member will be called as Kulapati or Grihapati. The eldest male member of Aryans were called as Kulapati or Grihapati. Now let us see about their marriages. Their marriages were mainly monogamy. Monogamy means normal, one man marrying one woman, that is monogamy. Polygamy existed only in royal families, that is one man marrying more than one woman, that existed only in royal family, that is among kings. So the marriages were mainly monogamy. Polygamy existed only in royal families. Widow remarriage was permitted and women had high status in society. The status of women were high. Example, you can tell there were many learned women during that time. Women were allowed to go for education. So there were many educated women. Two examples you can write, maybe Apala, Gosha were the learned women of Vedic period. So next is Chaturvarna system existed based on their occupation. That is Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. So Chaturvarna system existed, that is basically based on occupation, that is Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. So these are the main points in the first paragraph you can include, that is joint family system existed, the society was patriarchal, that means eldest male member was the head of the family. Head of the family was called as Kulapati or Grihapati. The marriages were monogamy. Polygamy existed only in royal families. Widow remarriage existed. Women had high status. They were given education. Example of two learned women, that is Apala and Gosha. Chaturvarna system existed based on their occupation, that is Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Now some changes started to happen during later Vedic age. That is same Aryan social condition only in Vedic age and later Vedic age some changes are there. So later Vedic age in marriage system, polygamy and polyandry started to become more popular. That is one man marrying more than one woman, one marrying more than one man. That is polygamy and polyandry started to become existent. The position of women slowly started deteriorating, that is woman position slowly started to become low, okay, and education were given only to women belonging to higher class. So you can easily find the difference between early Vedic and later Vedic. Early Vedic, women had a very good position, women were given education, marriages were monogamy, widow remarriage existed, everything was good during early Vedic age. But what happened in the later Vedic age? Polygamy, polyandry started in marriage system. Women position slowly started deteriorating. Education was only given to higher class women. And Varna system changed to caste system. That is, the division which was based on occupation later started to become caste system, which was hereditary. So Varna system changed to caste system. The life of an individual was divided into four ashramas, that is, Brahmacharya, student life, Grihastha, married life, Vanaprastha, retirement, and Sannyasa, that is, meditation. So the life of an individual was divided into four ashramas, Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasa. So in social condition of Aryans, we have four Varnas, that is Chaturvarna, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. We also have in later Vedic age four ashramas, that is Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyasa. Now let us see about the food which they ate. They mostly ate things made of wheat, rice, vegetables, fruits, milk, milk products, etc. Fish and meat was also used. They used two intoxicating drinks, that is Soma and Sura. These two drinks were mainly used during religious festivals or ceremonies. So food, wheat, rice, vegetables, fruit, milk, etc. were used. Fish and meat also were used. Soma and Sura were two intoxicating drinks which they used during that time. Now about their clothes, they wore cotton, clothes made of cotton and woolen, that is cotton and woolen clothes were used. Ornaments were used by both men and women. Both men and women use ornaments. Now what all type of ornaments, that is necklaces, finger rings, etc. were used by them. During their free time, they mainly did gambling, chariot racing, music, dance, etc. They also used some musical instruments like nagari, veena, flute, etc. So the food which they ate, wheat, rice, vegetable, fruit, milk, fish, meat. Soma and Sura were two intoxicating drinks. Clothes were made of cotton and wool. Ornaments were worn by both men and women. Examples are necklaces, finger rings, etc. During their free time, they did gambling, chariot racing, music, dance, and some of the musical instruments used by them were nagari, veena, flute, etc. So all these points are to be included in the question, social condition of Aryans. So once more, let us revise. Aryan social condition, we start with an introduction. The word Aryan means noble or person dependent on agriculture. They were different from Dravidians. Social condition, they had a joint family system. The family was patriarchal, that is eldest male member was the head of the family. Eldest male member was called as Kulapati or Grihapati. About their marriages, monogamy existed. Polygamy was only practiced in royal families. Widow remarriage existed. Women had high status. They were given education. Two learned women were Apala and Gosha. Chaturvarna system existed. That time it was based on occupation, that is Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Shudra. During later Vedic age, some changes started happening. In marriage system, polygamy and polyandry came to be existent. Women position deteriorated. Education was given only to women belonging to higher class. The Varna system changed to caste system, which later became hereditary. Life of an individual was divided into four ashramas, that is Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyasa. They mainly ate food made of wheat, rice, vegetable, fruit, milk, etc. Fish and meat were used. Soma and Sura were two intoxicating drinks. Clothes were made of cotton and wool. Ornaments were worn by both men and women. The main ornaments which they wore were necklaces, finger rings, etc. During their free time, they did gambling, chariot racing, music, dance, and some of the main musical instruments used by them were nagari, veena, flute, etc. All these points together make an answer for the question, social condition of Aryans. The next question which we are going to discuss is, explain the conquest of Samudragupta. This also is a 5-mark question. So we start with an introduction. Samudragupta was the greatest king of Gupta dynasty. Now whenever we write an answer about a king, we start with the point to which dynasty he belonged to. So Samudragupta was the greatest king of Gupta dynasty. His ambition was to become a Chakravarti. He is known for his military conquests. Now, from where do we get information about all this? We get information about his conquest from the Allahabad pillar inscription of Harisena. So this many points we had in the introduction. He was the greatest king of Gupta dynasty. His ambition was to become a Chakravarti. He was known for his military conquest. And we get information about all these from the Allahabad pillar inscription of Harisena. Now we directly move on to his conquest. His conquests are divided into four groups. They are the North Indian campaign, conquest of forest kingdom, South Indian campaign and conquest of border states. So now each point we are going to see what is the explanation to be included. First one, North Indian campaign. In North India, he defeated 9 kings and called it Digvijaya. Some of the kings defeated by him are Nandin, Balavarman, Nagasena, etc. So in North Indian campaign, he defeated 9 kings and called it Digvijaya. Some of the kings defeated by him in North India are Nandin, Balavarman, Nagasena, etc. The second one is conquest of forest kingdom. He conquered the forest kingdoms of Jabalpura, Nagpura, Vindhya regions, etc. So in forest kingdom, he conquered Jabalpura, Nagpura, Vindhya regions, etc. The third one is South Indian campaign. After North Indian campaign, he turned his attention towards South. In South India, he defeated 12 kings and called it Dharma Vijaya. It was called as Dharma Vijaya because the defeated kings accepted to pay tribute and remain as his vassals. So it was called as Dharma Vijaya. Some of the kings defeated in South India were Mahendra of Kosala, Vishnugopa of Kanchi, Hastivarman of Vengi, etc. So in South India, he defeated 12 kings. He called it Dharma Vijaya. The kings accepted to pay tribute and remain as his vassals. Example, Mahendra of Kosala, Vishnugopa of Kanchi, Hastivarman of Vengi, etc. The last one is conquest of border states. He conquered border states of Kamarupa in Assam, Kartripura in Punjab, etc. So conquest of border states, he conquered Kamarupa in Assam, Kartripura in Punjab, etc. Now after all these points, we write a conclusion. After conquering all these places, Samudragupta did Ashwamedha sacrifice and he took the title Ashwamedha Parakrama. So he performed Ashwamedha sacrifice after his conquest and took the title Ashwamedha Parakrama. He issued gold coins after his conquest and his empire extended from Kashmir in the north to Tamil Nadu in the south, Punjab in the west and Bengal in the east. He, other than being a great conqueror, he was also a poet, musician, scholar, etc. And he also had a title Kavi Raja. Because he was a great poet, he had the title Kavi Raja. So these many points you include in the conclusion. So all these points together, you have to write in the question Conquest of Samudragupta. So let us revise once more. As an introduction, he was the greatest king of Gupta dynasty. His ambition was to become a Chakravarti. He was known for his military conquest and we get information about all these from the Allahabad pillar inscription of Harisena. His conquest can be divided into four groups. The first one is North Indian campaign. He defeated 9 kings and called it Digvijaya. Some of the kings defeated by him were Nandin, Balavarman, Nagasena, etc. Second one is conquest of forest kingdom. He conquered Jabalpura, Nagpura, Vindhya regions, etc. Third one is South Indian campaign. After his North Indian conquest, he turned his attention towards South. He defeated 12 kings in South India and called it as Dharma Vijaya. The kings accepted to pay tribute and remain as his vassals. Example, Mahendra of Kosala, Vishnugopa of Kanchi, Hastivarman of Vengi. Next is conquest of border states. He conquered border states of Kamarupa in Assam, Kartripura in Punjab, etc. As a conclusion, you can write, after conquering all these places, he performed Ashwamedha sacrifice and took the title Ashwamedha Parakrama. He issued gold coins. His empire extended from Kashmir in the north, Tamil Nadu in the south, Punjab in the west, and Bengal in the east. Other than being a great conqueror, he was a poet, musician, scholar, etc. And he had one more title, that is Kavi Raja. All these points together, you have to write when a question comes, explain the conquest of Samudragupta.